Good morning, my amazing students. I hope that you all are fine with your mind. So today we are going to discuss part 5th of the chapter Deep Water by William O. Douglas. Okay. William O. Douglas, this is story Deep Water. This story Deep Water we have taken is taken out from where? Of Man and Mountains. Many times I have repeated it in the class to make you understand, to please recall it, that this story Deep Water is taken out from Of Man and Mountains, okay, by William O. Douglas. So William O. Douglas, this autobiographical account, okay, Deep Water, gives us the message, first message, that childhood fear should not be tackled easily, okay. The childhood fear is, if not treated properly, they make deep inroads in us. ऐसा होता है कि बचपन का जो डर होता है, that will grab your spirit, okay, it happens. So we will see in this chapter what is basically is taught. Where there is a will, there is a way. Where there is a will, जहाँ चाहा वहाँ रहा, means डर के आगे जीत है माउंटेन ड्यू. How? Means if you have a fear, अगर आपको कोई डर है, if you have a fear and if you would like to, if you are determined, sheer determined, courage is with you, then you can finally win the fear. आप विन कर लेंगे उस फियर को. So same thing is taught, same thing is discussed here. Discussion of fear means journey from fear to win. Means क्या है fear? Fear से लेके जो win की, conquer की या victory की जो journey, that is discussed over here. Okay, so we will see over here. Up to now what we have studied at William Douglas, since childhood he had developed childhood fear, what aquaphobia. उसका बचपन से एक डर है, that is aquaphobia. Why? Because one incident happened when he was 3 or 4 years old. That incident happened when he was 3 or 4 years old. वो incident कब होता है? California में. Okay, when he was enjoying California beach, okay, waves suddenly knocked him down. Okay, that incident happened just for a moment, for few minutes. So it did not settle in his mind. Okay. Second incident happened, misadventure happened when he was 10 or 11 years old. And where was it? It was in the swimming pool at YMCA. I have already discussed what is YMCA. YMCA, Young Men's Christian Association. A pool at YMCA. Misadventure happened there. So what was the misadventure? A big bully. Big brusher, means a boy seemed bully, threw him into the deep end of the pool. Swimming pool was two or three feet deep at one end, and the other end it was 9 feet. ये मैंने आपको clear करवाया था, and the drop was gradual. So swimming pool was very safe, and William Douglas was confident enough to learn swimming over there. But misadventure happened after 3 days. क्या हुआ? A big bully. When William Douglas had not learned swimming, अभी तक नहीं आया उसको. And prior to it, what happened? A big bully threw him into the deep end of the pool. Okay. Now he was going down, and before he was going down, but his wits were working, and he made a strategy that he would jump, when his feet would touch the bottom, jab uske feet touch karenge bottom ko, he would make a big jump and come to the surface like a cork ki tarah upar aa jayega. But what happened? He jumped. First bar jab usko dhakka mara, he reached and he jumped with all fours, and he came up very slowly. वो ऊपर बहुत धीरे धीरे आता है, and his eyes and nose came out. Yesterday I had cleared in my video that his eyes and nose came out and he flared it, means he waved his arms. उसने अपने हाथों को हिलाया. He would like to ask for help, but no rope, no ladder, nothing was there, and nobody was there to help him, and he was going down for second time in the swimming pool. So he compared the situation. What? He was going down second time in the swimming pool, and he compared that as something was pulling me inside. मुझे दूसरी बार कोई पानी में कोई खींच रहा है. As you are fighting with irresistible force, in a nightmare. Okay, and he was going down. His legs became paralyzed. Hands were not working. He was suffocating over there. His head throbbed. His head was beating. Only two body parts made him understand that he was alive. Do cheeze itself only. What? Heartbeat and pounding in the heart and the head's beating. Means heart's beating conveyed him that he was alive. Then he was going down, but still one strategy was in his mind that he would jump or come out. Again, when he reached for the second time in the swimming pool, he jumped with all force and he came out. What happened? Only eyes and nose, but not mouth. So over here, one thing was mentioned, stark terror. Aisa kyun ho raha hai? Means He was trying, but he was not getting out. वो try कर रहा है लेकिन फिर भी वो बाहर नहीं आ पा रहा है. So, severe terror seized him completely. Grabbed him. उसको पूरे को उसने, severe terror ने उसको क्या कर लिया है, उसको बिल्कुल clutch कर लिया. William Douglas was clutched in severe terror, stark terror. So, he felt that it was like electricity charge and he was going down. Okay? Then again he jumped. वो वापस से कोशिश करता है सेकेंड बार जंप करने का. ओके, सेकेंड जंप करता है एंड ही केम अप. वापस ऊपर आता है, थर्ड टाइम ऊपर आता है. एंड आइज एंड नोज ओनली. ओके, आइज और नोज ओनली. एंड देन अगेन ही वॉज गोइंग डाउन फॉर थर्ड टाइम. वी हैव टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर. अप टू नाउ हमने देखा कि दो बार, एक बार तो फर्स्ट टाइम बिग बुली ने उसको फेंका. ही ट्राइड एंड देन ही ट्राइड एंड केम अप. एंड देन ही वॉज गोइंग डाउन फॉर द सेकेंड टाइम. ही ट्राइड to jump and he came up. Upar aya, eyes and nose. Now he was going down for the third time. Okay, so we have to start from here, page number 27, and you have to start from here. And then strangely there was light. Means he came out after second jump. Wo bahar aata hai. I was coming out of awful yellow water. Okay, at least my eyes were, my nose was almost out too. And I started down a third time. Means he was going down, okay, third time. First time big bully threw him, second time jab wo ja raha tha to usko kaisa feel ho raha hai, that some force was pulling him. Now third time he was going down. I sucked for air, I tried to breathe and got water, but gulped water. I would like to breathe, मुझे सांस लेनी है, but पानी, I gulped water. The yellowish light was going out. Means the light that I felt, means while going up, that was going out. It means I was going again, the, in which area? In the 9 feet. मैं वापस से 9 feet वाले area में जा रहा हूँ. Then all efforts ceased. Then he stopped making all efforts. He did not want to make any effort. I relaxed. Why? Because he had stopped all his efforts. He did not want to try anymore. Even my legs felt limp. Means what? That is, legs were not supporting him. Okay? Then he stopped. Making efforts, and he thought that now he would not save himself. Now all the efforts were in vain. He would not save himself. वो नहीं बच पाएगा. He came to know. So, and a blackness swept over my brain. Blackness means blackout. His brain experienced a blackout. Means why? Whenever you are tired, okay, means you are it much tired that you don't want to do anything, then blackness means you would like to take rest. Same thing has happened over here. Due to these hard efforts, he was experiencing blackout. Means his mind was now not working and he would like to sleep. He felt drowsy. Usko drowsy feel ho raha hai. And a blackness swept over my brain. It wiped out all fear. It wiped out means what? That it cleared all fear, wiped out terror, and now there was no terror. Why? Because he was drowsy. Blackness was there. Blackout was experienced by his brain. Uska jo brain hai, it was experiencing blackout. So when you are in sleep, suppose in case you have a fear, but if you go for sleep, then what would happen? That fear would not exist for some time during your sleep. So same thing, wiped out terror. There was no more panic. There was no more panic means William Douglas felt that it was now all in vain. He should not feel panic. He should not feel panic. It was quiet. It was quiet and peaceful. It was very peaceful. Why? Because now he felt drowsy. Nothing to be afraid of. He thought that what is the use of being afraid? Kya darna hai? Because his end was near. This is nice to be drowsy, to go to sleep. No need to jump. He did not want to jump anymore. Too tired to jump. He got tired with jumping and all. Bichara itne efforts kar chuka hai. He was tired. It is nice to be carried gently. And suddenly he was floating. As you are floating in the sky, there's a gravitational force nahi hota hai space mein. In the same way, he was floating in the water. Swimming pool mein float kar raha hai because he did not know how to swim. Floating, okay? To float along in the space, thunder arms around me. Suddenly, he felt that his mother put the tender arms around him. Uski mummy ne usko kya kar liya hai? Means tender arms around him. Tender arm like mother and now I must go to sleep, and he went for sleep. Means he felt drowsy and suddenly all efforts were ceased and he went for sleep. Means he felt tired, weak, and he crossed the oblivion. I crossed to oblivion means now he became unconscious. Wo kya ho chuka tha? Unconscious. State of being unconscious. Oblivion means state of being unconscious. Unconscious means he did not know what was happening around him. Usko nahi pata ab kya ho raha hai. He felt unconscious and the curtain of life fell and he drifted away towards death. He felt that he was now moving towards death. Okay, so he drifted away. He was moving towards death. The next I remember, I was lying on my stomach beside the pool vomiting. Next he remembered when he came in conscious. Jab wo hosh mein aaya, next he remembered that when he came in conscious, little bit conscious, then he came to know that he found himself near the edge of the swimming pool. Swimming pool ke bahar aa gaya and he was vomiting. The chap that threw me in was saying, but I was only fooling. So someone, a voice was scolding the chap. Us ladke ko daant rahi thi, big bully ko, that what you have done with this child. Someone said the kid nearly died. A voice was scolding chap. Kya? Us ladke ko, that the boy was nearly died. Means Douglas, this boy was about to die. Be all right now. Everything is in their hand now. Abhi sab kuch sahi hai. Let's carry him to the locker room. So the voice ordered. So might be the voice was of manager, instructor, whosoever. He take him to the locker room where he could change and all. Several hours later, after many hours, he came in conscious. I walked home. William Douglas walked home. He felt very weak. Why? Because the incident happened in the swimming pool, settled, grabbed. Everywhere grabbed him. Usko bilkul usko kya kar liya, clutch kar liya, grab kar liya. And trembling. Suppose in case you don't know how to swim and you are thrown into the swimming pool for around 15 minutes and you tried there and then you lost in oblivion, unconscious state. Same thing would happen over there. Trembling. He was shrieking. He was shivering. Wo bilkul shiver kar raha hai. Kaap raha hai with fear. I shook and cried. I was shaking and cry. Mean when I lay on my bed, when William Douglas lay on his bed at night, he cried because that incident settled in his mind, heart, everywhere. And I could not eat that night. Why? Because vomiting was there, so he was not able to eat anything. For days, a haunting fear. 4 days. So that incident made him physically what? Weak. 4 days, a haunting fear was in my heart. The slightest exertion upset me. So wherever he went, the little bit work upsets him. He was physically weak. Why? Because that incident was in his mind, heart, everywhere. Same thing. Whenever any person met a bitter experience or met a bad incident, so what would happen with that person? That person was influenced with that incident. Wo bilkul usse kya ho jata, influenced ho jata. Wo next he is not able to do anything. Same thing has happened over here. The slightest little bit work exertion work upset me, making me wobbly in the knees. He felt weakness in his knees. This body was not supporting him. Okay, he got tired with little work and sick to my stomach. For many days, he did vomiting. I never went back to the pool. I feared water. So he never went back to the pool. So now he decided he did not want to go near pool. Means swimming pool, the memory of the YMCA pool, whenever it revived in his mind, so that created a horror in his mind. So he decided not to go near water. I feared water and I avoided it whenever I could. So he remained away from the water. He decided to remain away from the water. A few years later, now the second part starts from here. So what has happened up to here? That he tried all his after third fall, means when he went down, he lost in consciousness. Okay, he lost in unconscious state. He lost in unconscious state, and when he came in conscious, that fear has settled in his mind, heart, everywhere. So now we would see what would be impact of that swimming pool incident in his life. We will see in the next video. Thank you. Have a nice day.